पे जाके उसको देख भी, अगर वो यूनिवर्सिटी चेक कर रही है आपकी सब चीज़ों को, सो दे आर ऑल्सो चेकिंग दीज थिंग्स, सो ट्राई टू मेंटेन दैट एज वेल, रेगुलरली चेक योर लेक्चर्स एंड इफ यू फील लाइक if something you'd like to explore more, because once you listen something for the second time, it will definitely give you benefit. Okay. So today we have the session of practice, because we have completed how we're supposed to write the letter. I have found only one student who has responded back to me on the assignment. The rest will write down like that. So I'll show her work with you people over here. Okay. Just hold on for a second. Okay, now it has got two students. One is Aditi and second one is Nitesh Kumar. Let's read first of all the sheet of Aditi. There was a question about write a complaint letter to DD Company of Ludhiana for delivering washing machine which has got some problems, invent the necessary detail for writing that. Okay, so that was the question to you. So let's see how she has written. Okay, answer me one thing. As she has written, Aditi, you tell me that you have written like that. So, do you feel somewhere that it is more formal now, the format we have followed? Have you seen any change in it, like the way it was taught to us and the way we are writing now? Is there any change? Do you feel like? Aditi is there?
Yes, sir. So actually, there is a network issue and I'm not getting your voice properly.
Okay. I was just asking, the letter you wrote, did you find some change into it, like the way in schools it was taught and right now we are writing in a very professional manner? You know, I think you have noticed any kind of a change into it. Am I right?
Yes, sir. Actually, in schools, we are not taught about in much detailed, but...
Right. Okay. So, means our server, our purpose is served, right? So, now you are getting the answer of everything, that why this is written here, why this is written here, why this is written here, right? Now, you know this thing. So, everybody, I think the screen is in front of you. If you see, she wrote, this is the address of herself, 56C, Haboval, Kalan, Ludhiana. Then she wrote the date. Then she wrote the name and the address of a company, very nice. So she invented the detail now. Because I just gave the detail that there is a company called DD Company from Ludhiana. So she invented detail, means she wrote even, or she added model town as well. Now we have another part which is called as subject. So we wrote here complaining about the washing machine. So rather we write down complaining, Aditi, we can write down complaint about, okay? A complaint letter, a complaint about washing machine, that would come over. Now coming up to your salutation, you simply wrote sir. So there is one thing that is missing, which is called as greetings. So students, what it should be added over here? Respected. Yes, students, you all are into the class. Please answer me. What do you think? And is it right if we apply respected over here?
Sir, this is complaint, so it's not necessary to add.
It is not necessary to apply. Okay. Anyone else? Should we apply something over here? Yes, anyone
else? So we can use dear Mr. Yes. Mr. something like that.
No, that's fine. If we do not know the person's name or the title, or even we do not know the who is on the other end. So dear, it must be applied. Only applying sir.
Yes, sir. Only dear.
Right. So we're supposed to apply dear sir. So dear sir is more appropriate because dear means we are trying to greet that person. Sir, we are trying to show the respect. Okay. Coming up to next, and I'm very sorry to inform you that the washing machine. I am very sorry. You know, it seems like here, Aditi, that you are at the end where you committed any mistake, right? So we're supposed to use something like that. It is regret to inform you that. No, regret word is pachtawa. You know, the person who has sold you that machine, he or she should feel the pain, the mistake they have done. It was not their mistake, so it's not sorry from your side. Sorry should come from their side. You can write down, it is regret to inform you that. Okay, okay, the machine which has bought from this and this and this, very good. You invented the detail like cash number 250, very good. It 10th May this with 1 year guarantee, stopped working well after 1 week. The machine, now the machine makes an unbearable noise and his spinner's motor is not absorbing water from the clothes. Good. All this is creating great inconvenience and I feel cheated being your regular customer. Very nice. I humbly request you either replace it or send any specialist who can remove its faults. Your quick action will be appreciated and also I shall be thankful to you for this favor. Up to here it's fine, Aditi. I humbly request you to either replace it or send any specialist who can remove its faults. Your quick action will be appreciated, fine. And also I shall be thankful to you for your favor. This is not a favor, that's your duty, right? So they are not giving you any favor. They have committed mistake, I mean they have sent you the machine which has got faults and it's not working well. So the customer, that's their duty. It's not like they are giving you favor. So be strong over here. You wrote very nicely. Three lines means you're requesting humbly to them. So it's a first reminder, I can say that. So we cannot be harsh over here. So it's just skip this line, the favor one. Simply even write and I shall be thankful to you. And I expect or I hope that the problem will be soon as possible. If it will be second reminder, then you have to be a little harsh on that part where you add up like before going or opting any other, legal remedial measures. I expect from you that you would soon solve it. Okay, so that's the line which can be added. If you will write down for the second time, yours faithfully, Aditi. Perfectly, it's nice. There were a few things which I can tell you. These are the recommendations and suggestions. But I do not say that something was wrong here. It was just a suggestion to you that you can add these things over here. So that's perfectly fine. Very nice. Okay. We call the formal letter. Let's see how Nitish has written. And even we can see she has followed the one format. Can anyone tell me what is the format she followed over here?
Blog.
Very good. This is blog. Blog, full blog. Yes, full blog format, which has been followed by Aditi. All right. So coming up to letter of Nitish. Dhyana. K-H-A-N-A, Khanna, Punjab. Khanna, what is this? What are the spellings of Khanna? Nitesh, are you there? Is it Khanna or something else?
Khanna, sir.
Khanna ke spelling nahi bata? K-H-A-N-N-A. Dhyana, Khanna, Punjab, yes. March 5. So this is your address. Okay. Then there is a date, March 5. Then the recipient's address, the dealer, Messrs. Sharma and Didi Company. Okay. Then we have a subject, complaint regarding a defective washing machine. First of all, before I read, you have seen Aditi's letter and your letter is also over here. Okay. When the paper, it will come. So right now, if I take example of, because right now open book exams are going on and in our MSc even you would do the same. So see this thing, your letters are somehow, you know, not in a proper alignment. Here you have left this much space, here you came up to just extreme to the left, here again you left the space. So the format is not followed. That's very important, I'm trying to tell you. You know, the person is same. When a person, you know, you see everyday actor and actresses, and you must have also seen there are a few blogs which are made that how these people look without makeup, right? So this is something without makeup. You know, the makeup is the format, so we're supposed to follow it. So if you're using, you know, modified, then it should come on the side. But if you are using it, the full block, then these things, these are the mistakes you are committing, and this can, you know, make you lose your marks, because the question is of everything. Okay, the question is of your writing, the question is of your format, question is of your parts of the letter as well. Okay, so you wrote nicely over here, but if I try to compare, look over here, you know, this is the address, one line she left, then she wrote over there, one line she left, again she wrote like that. So I can understand there were lines, and in your case you do not have lines over here, and this is the right way basically, because in your paper you cannot use sheets with the lines, because in your final paper especially they would ask you to, you know, write onto the white sheets which you're supposed to upload. But ultimately you can keep these things in your mind. This is one over here, Punjab should come over here, March is here, Leela over here, message should also come on this one. Then just next to it, it should come over here, subject. It should start from here, subject. Complaint regarding a defective washing machine, okay? Sir, you also wrote, sir. You also missed dear over here. And you started this in the same line, that is again wrong, right? If it's sir over here, dear sir, we're supposed to write into the next line. Cannot write into the same line. A month ago, I purchased a washing machine from your company outlet, white case, memo number 0852, date February 5 to 2020, for about a month. Look, you wrote two things twice. One is here, a month ago, then you again wrote here, for about a month. Right, so in the one paragraph you have repeated that month, okay, for about a month ago. It's exactly that is, its working was satisfactory. Now its working was satisfactory, now here you're applying was, then you are saying now, because if you want to connect that now with this line, that a comma should come over here, not over here. Okay, it was working satisfactory, comma, then, but now it has started giving trouble. It makes a noise and stops. It has started giving trouble. It makes noise. It stops on its own all of a sudden. The machine doesn't wash. Look, your words are not matching. A is there, you is there, date is there, then this, you. Try to see. Follow one. You can make one straight line over here. Just try to follow that, everything. It should align in that way. Or there's no need even, you know, to draw a line. When you wrote one word, just try to follow that everything. If you want to follow the full block format, everything, it will come just right over here, just under the L. Okay. Now it has started giving the word, it makes noise and stops and so on. All of a sudden the machine doesn't wash the clothes properly. Okay. I am sure some manufacturing defect has impaired its working. Since the machine is within the guarantee period, I request you to replace it at the earliest. I have been your regular customer and purchased. I have been your regular customer, then you're supposed to add. This is present perfect continuous. So you try to correlate with some last date. If you do not want to mention this thing, then I am your regular customer. Okay, I have been a regular customer since 2010. Since this, so the person would be explaining that I have a relation of these many years. Otherwise, you just simply write that, you know, that I am your regular customer and purchase articles on your impress recommendation and good faith, hoping for an immediate replacement of the washing machine. Yours sincerely, Nitish Kumar. Okay, it's fine. You wrote nicely, but I think you can see first appearance, as I gave you a very raw example of, you know, performers, like when they will come in front of you without makeup and with makeup, you know, the entire impression would be different. So similar is the situation over here, because if you do not bring the right format, you know, the exact impression will be different. You're doing, that's why we're doing practice. Else is fine. You explain that the first paragraph you try to make the connection. Second, you talked about the problem you're facing in the first. The third paragraph you wrote, okay, you're expecting that, you know, they would change or you know, fix that machine as soon as possible. That's fine. This has got problem of format, I can say. Right? Okay, so let's see who else has written now. Only two people. What about others?
Sir, I delivered wrong. Sir, I put it. Can you check it?
Here, over here, or into the class comments? Let me see. No, I do not see anything in the class comments. So. Okay, there are few it has come. I'm running the same. What's your good name, beta? Mohammed Sajid?
This is Sajid.
Sajid, I cannot see. I think sometimes it takes time. You just have, just now you have posted, or you posted yesterday? Did you post today,
sir,
or
I posted
yesterday?
Now.
That's why I said that.
Today, sir. Recently.
Okay. It's not yet uploaded. There are two assignments. That is, one is of Aditi, another one is of Nitish.
Sir, check in private comments, sir. It was there.
Private comments, okay. Class comments, right? No class comments. Then you have attached something or not? Did you?
No, sir, I have not.
Private comments, I do not know, like, where your private comments it goes. Can you see the private comments here? Can you do the same thing which you did last time? I think you're supposed to post in your what do you call attachments? I do not see any option available for the private comments. There are class comments and we have attachment. And this would be probably your private comment.
Sir, I put it now.
Okay. Yes. The MST, your MST should also come like that, okay? That's also very important. The MST should also come like that. Write a complaint letter. Private comments. मोहम्मद साजिद जीएससी फर्स्ट ईयर गुलजार ग्रुप ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूट्स आएगा ध्याना देन वी हैव डेट देन वी हैव डीडी कंपनी खन्ना लुधियाना ओके द एड्रेस देन वी हैव सब्जेक्ट कंप्लेंट अबाउट वॉशिंग मशीन दैट यू डिलीवर्ड डियर सर ओके सो अप टू हियर वी हैव फॉलोड 1 2 3 4 5 सो वी डिस्कस्ड यस्टरडे 5 types and sorry 5 paths so we applied those 5 paths over okay, fine now we come up to the first paragraph this is regular customer I am writing this letter to inform you that you delivered the machine this is regular customer you know this is not starting Sajid you're supposed to you know open up by writing something that this is Mohammed Sajid and I am your regular customer something like that I'm writing this letter to inform you that your letter the machine is not working properly. That's fine. Yes, this is the first introductory paragraph, and then you come up to the second. It's really sad to inform you that washing machine that I was delivered is not working properly. It starts heating whenever we use. I'm very disappointed with your service, as I have trusted in your company. That's why I ordered from your company. Service is also you know not very much appropriate over here because they have delivered you on time the problem here it comes into the product so we talk about this is the manufacturing you know defect but it's fine if you write this thing. I trusted your company, that's why I ordered your company. I hope you will wind up my problem soon. Delivered is past. Delivered means it has already been done. You will, right? You're supposed to, yes, it is supposed to be. It is supposed to be in future that you will deliver.
So it is typing problem.
Right?
It is typing problem, sir.
And that's fine. It's happened. Okay, I will wind up my problem soon and will deliver proper machine which I am looking for. Very sincerely, Sajid, you wrote here, dear sir, here you ended up with sincerely. So we discussed like if your salutation is dear sir or madam, you're supposed to be here faithfully, but yes, it is accepted. Why it is accepted? Because you write dear sir over here because you do not know the name of the person. So it's not wrong over here. You are sincerely fine. Spellings are, you know, some problem issue, but you have said that it is typing mistake. Sajid Cheryar, Gujarat Group of Institutes, SIGA, Lithana. So that's fine. Okay, it comes over here now. So how do I have to see that private command? Now you see that, you know, where it goes if I say, if I type over here. Okay. So, do you get it? Right. So, I think there should be something that you can see. So, format is good. You followed left aligned. But here you skipped something. So which format you have followed? Sajid?
Semi-block. Semi-block.
Very good. Very good. That's a semi-block format because you took this thing a little away from the left extreme. And they are matching over here. So the format is right. Everything that is aligned to the left-hand margin. Good. See, semi-block format. Just it has a few suggestions that you know the starting which should be there you know should have been amended this one is right then for this thing that's right but instead of service you can talk about the product because they have not yet given you the service I hope you will solve my problem rather than wind up is something you end up. here is we are expecting to solve it. I hope you'll solve my problem soon and deliver, and we'll deliver the proper, not a proper, we'll deliver new machine which I'm looking for. Okay. So they could repair and send you. So you should just say
okay,
that.
Okay, sir.
Right? Otherwise, everything else is fine. Okay, good. Yes, who else has posted?
Sir.
Haan ji beta.
Sir, letter वैसे कितने marks की होगी हमारी?
It depends. Sometime maximum of the time it comes for 15 marks. 1-5.
So, sir, we need to invent more details and put
yes,
some more.
Yes, yes, yes. That's why I've told you that in this is what you call. I'm not, saying anything, but this is something if I take up, this is more of the matter if you write down an email. For letter, we're supposed to add at least one more paragraph. If you remember, then I took your lecture. I suggested this thing that, the paragraph. Like over here, if you see, you wrote one, then this is very, the information is very small, or you just come up to the conclusion, right? So there should be first paragraph, that is introduction, leave one space, then start the second paragraph. Thing was, first was introduction, second was your problem defining. Third was your conclusion. So you can, but if a letter, it would come for 10 marks, that is sufficient. But if the letter will come for 15 marks, then you're supposed to add another paragraph in between of it. Means your body paragraph should be of two paragraphs. One is introduction, then one paragraph for defining, another paragraph for again to extend something, then third paragraph for conclusion. You can add something over here. Means as you wrote over here, spinners motor is now absorbing water from the tube. So you can add something over here, right? You can add more complications or, you can talk about the points which comes into the warranty, right? Look here, you just wrote one line, that is a 1 year warranty, okay? Warranty guarantees. So here you can add up something by writing like it is under warranty period. So I am worried that you will not send me the engineer to, repair it, because this is just brand new product and I could not expect that on a very second day or just after a month, it would start getting repaired. So as I'm a good customer, I expect from you that you will send me a new product on, in place of this one, because this is not working properly, and if this is not like time it has gone like 5 months or 6 months, it's just been you can say that just been few days and it has started giving problems. So this is something a matter you could increase into your second paragraph. So altogether there will be 4 paragraph for 15 marks. If you write down for 10 marks, then I can say this thing that yes, you can write 3 paragraphs: introduction, your body, and conclusion. That's it. But if the question, the letter, it will come for 15 marks, then should be 4 paragraphs: first for introduction, 2 paragraph for explanation, 4th paragraph for conclusion. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much.
Anyone else who has posted or written? Haan ji beta, haan ji.
Sir, I have a question.
Yes, please.
So, what is the word limit, for example, if this kind of letter will come?
This will be written. This will come into your paper. This will come into your paper. They'll tell you that, you're supposed to write down in 200 words or 250 words or 300 words. I told you that, it depends upon marks. Because if they'll ask you a question, for 10 marks, they'll not exceed the word limits of 200. But if a question would come for 15 marks, then yes, for sure, they will increase the word limit. So it will be mentioned into your paper. You need not to worry about it. Let's see, do they mention? Because this is what I'm expecting. This is the actual way as per the Bloom's taxonomy that, you know, the word limit should be mentioned. But let's see your paper, that what it has, you know, mentioned over there. Guys, it is assigned to 113 students and only 3 have appeared, you know. This is very, very sad. And you want me to write down the complaint letter to you? That it is where, regretfully, I'm informing you that only 3 students have appeared. We are doing this practice for your exams. We are doing this practice that, you know, you will learn it for your practical life. Okay, so this is not something, you know, that we are just making our copies blank. It's very important and very interesting thing, you know, when you write down, look, everything. Now you can write down a letter to anybody. I have heard a lot of time a question, it comes that students, they even don't know how to write a letter. They have passed their entire degree and they don't know how to write a letter. Might, you know, in your future time, you're supposed to write down letter to your HOD, to your director, to probably the main office, to probably the executive director. You know, there are chances you might write down letters to the authorities. So now you are competent, you are confident that this is the format of writing a proper formal letter. Now you can write. So you will see what impression, what nice impression you will leave on. This is for lifetime. This is not for one, you know, this is practical. This is for lifetime. It's not for one lecture. Those who have, you know, grabbed it, so that would be for entire life. Right? This is what I'm trying to do over here. I teach and I try to do practice with you guys, so you will become competent writing it. And you will see that this will help you in the papers and of course into your practical life. Whole question paper, okay. Let's see what it says. You can refer this thing for your worries and how it will come into your paper. Look, of 15 marks letter, it has come for 15. A customer has complained against the defective makeup and skincare products of your company. As a sales manager of a company, get a letter to the customer apologizing for such inconvenience caused to him in the necessary details. Yes, Abid, they have not written here the number of words, so that's supposed to be more than 250 words. It is in between of 250 to 300 words if it comes for the 15 marks. You cannot just write down in 100 words. Okay. Now, another thing is, if you watch over here, they have changed your position. The letter we wrote, we did the practice on, that was that you were writing a letter to the company, defective product, it has, you know, has been bought by you, and you're writing that letter to the company that, okay, you know, you were expecting something good from them and this is what I have got. But here in a question, they made you a sales manager of that company. So now what you're doing, your next assignment is the letter, like 3 of you, you know, I can say this thing. It depends upon you, but look, I can encourage you, I can motivate you, I can tell you that this is for your, you know, this is for the betterment in practical life. But if you're not doing it, you are losing a very good experience of it. So for those 3 students, the letter you wrote, now you have to reply to that letter. So question here comes, that is the reply letter, means you are working in an organization and you have received a complaint letter from the customer and you are sales manager of that company and you are you're supposed to write down a letter. So it's a reply letter. So you take now that letter you just have written, that is the letter in the form of a question to you. Are you getting me, Aditi, Abid, and Nitesh?
Yes, sir.
Right, so this is your question now. So now you have to reply, you have to write a reply to that question. Now you are a sales manager, you have received a complaint letter that you are working for, you are, for example, computer science engineer, you're working for Bosch, okay, and Samsung, any of the company, okay. So you are into, you're a sales manager over there, and just made you, you're working on that position. So you could be engineer, you could be salesperson, you could be anybody. So it depends upon, they'll ask the question. So here they made you salesperson. So they ask that this is a letter you have received, that your machine is defective. So how do you reply? So that's the question. Okay. First thing they ask you, apologizing. You need to apologize for such inconvenience caused to them. Try to understand. I'm not just trying to tell you that these are parts of it. These are the types of writing the letter. Now our duty is to learn how to make it effective, what tone I should use into it. It's into business, right? So you should learn that how can I impress whosoever is your audience. So here your audience is unsatisfied customer. So to calm down, to make them at a place that yes, your problem would definitely be listened to, you're supposed to write in that way. That is the art. That is why, it is called as art of letter writing. That is the art, right? That is an art. So now what you're supposed to do, you apologize first of all that this is the inconvenience which is caused to you, and we are really sorry for that. We could not expect this thing. And I assure you that this is, this is at a minimum. So that minimum when it has happened, otherwise we do not have any problem the machines we have sent to our companies. Okay, so you just try to make something like that. So there's a question which is mentioned here that you're supposed to invent the necessary detail. You're supposed to invent the necessary details. So that's why you come up over here. You come up over here that in a way that feel like that is exactly it is happening. When once you save a customer, you will have a different kind of a rapport. Okay. Okay. All right, so let's see something else as well. At the end, what we will do, we'll solve these things. What I'm trying to tell you over here, my point of concern is this. You are all our engineers and you know mathematics very well than me. So Aditi, can you count with me? What is this?
Yes, sir.
What is this? Where my cursor is?
15, sir.
Then what is this?
15, sir.
What is this?
10, sir.
So all together, how much?
40, sir.
40, okay. And this is your comprehension. That will come for? 4, 6, 8, 10. Okay. So 40 plus 10?
50, sir.
And how many marks of paper it will come to you? Can you tell me?
70.
No.
60,
sir. 60. 100 marks of paper, 60 for exams, 40 for your internal. So you can see your 50 marks are right here. 50 marks are right over there. So these things are going to decide you not only get pass but get good marks or not. So that's from a paper side, exam side. And if we talk about from the practical side, so all practical. This is all for your practical life. The letter, you should know that how we're supposed to write it. Now, up to now, you have got we call the skill of writing an email, and of course a letter. And what is formal letter? What would be the format of it? I think I have promised to you that I'll tell you that why we place the date on left hand side or right hand side. It has a question. It has a mark. And now it is clear to you. If anybody would ask you that, okay, Aditi, you have placed your date on right hand side, and this segment is on left hand side. Why are you doing it? So you have an answer. I am following the format. I am following modified format. I'm following semi block. I'm following full block. Okay, guys. Yes. Is it clear, everybody? Please.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Was it good? How was the lecture?
Great, sir.
Yes, sir.
Interesting. It was nice and interesting.
Was nice and interesting. Good. Thank you so much. But I expect from you there are only 4 or 5 students those who are active into the class. And I have told so many times, it's not something which sometimes we think of that would not come again into our life. This is something which will be continuous in your life. Okay, so please do practice on it. It's not just for the exams, it's for your life. So you will be very confident, I promise you. Next time when you will write something, you'll be very much confident. Okay, I know grammar, I know letter, I know, email. I have written essays, so I have a lot of ideas in my mind. My thought process is working very fine. So tomorrow when you'll sit for the interview, you sit for the group discussion, you will be 100% confident. Right? So I expect that you follow these things. And best of luck for your life and of course for your exams. Thank you so much, guys. And let me take now your attendance.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. Let me take your attendance real quick. Don't type your attendance. I would ask today. Okay. It's CSCA 750, roll number 750, 750. Okay, 751, 752, 54, 56. Unmute yourself. All unmute yourself because I am asking for the roll numbers. You all supposed to answer it. Anil Balmiki, I have seen you into the class. Why are you not responding? Anil Balmiki, I've seen you somewhere. Okay, let me first of all stop that recording.